Nicole, and I can't see a thing with these things on. Today is the day of the eclipse, and as I look up, it started. It's about a quarter of the way across, but I can't see a thing, so let me go ahead and take these things off. And this is exactly what happens when you go and you talk to a homeowner. They are not able to see the reality of their situation. They don't know what's really going on when they're in foreclosure. And that's your job, is to help them. Just a second, sweetheart, okay? It's my daughter calling my name. So what happens is when you go to them is they're in denial. They're like, oh yeah, I got this thing figured out, and I can resolve this. And what's really happening is they have these blinders on. They're like this, you know. Other than looking at the one true thing you're trying to look for is, you know, here I'm looking at the sun. Other than that, I can't see anything else. It's dark. And that's what they are. They only see the one thing. They're like, oh, you know what? All I can see is that I'm in my house now, and that's all that's going to matter. I'm going to stay in my house. And you have to help them see the consequences of them not taking control of their actions. One is that, you know, of course, they will be foreclosed upon. Two, there is a possibility that they could get what's called a judicial judgment for anything that is of over. So for whatever the purchase price is, let's say they go to foreclosure for $100,000 and they owe $150,000. And there's also damage done to the property that's going to be another $30,000. They are on the hook for that extra $30,000 plus that $50,000. So that's $80,000. They can get a judicial judgment, and the judge can rule in favor of the banks and sue them. Not only that, let's say it does go, and that's only if it's a judicial foreclosure. Now, there's two types of foreclosures. Not all states are dual, like California, Oregon. These are dual states. Other states are just either straight up just judicial or straight up just trustee, which is non-judicial. And California is mostly a non-judicial. But here's what happens on a non-judicial foreclosure. People can say, oh, you know what, it's not a judicial, therefore I'm not going to be sued for whatever is, you know, the deficiency, that deficiency judgment. Not true, because what happens is on a non-judicial foreclosure, there's still that gap, that difference. And the Mortgage Forgiveness Act that was initiated by the Bush administration in 2007 ended on January 1st, 2017. So, and that only applies to your primary residence. So for any investment property that you have that goes into foreclosure, you are on the hook for that difference. The IRS will make you claim that on your taxes. You're going to get a 1099-C at the end of the year from your mortgage company, and you got to file that. If you don't file that, then you're going to be, you know, it's considered fraud, of course, by the IRS. Again, I'm not a tax accountant, so don't, you know, quote me on this. You know, do your own verification and your own homework. But the reality of the situation is that homeowners who think that, oh, you know what, hey, you know, I'm not going to get a judicial judgment. It's true, you might not get a judicial judgment, but you definitely are going to get a 1099-C, and at the end of the year, that's going to be taxed at ordinary income. So in our same scenario where you have a home that is sold at a foreclosure auction for $100,000 and there's a remaining balance of $150,000, so there's, you know, $50,000 difference, you're going to get taxed at the end of the year for that $50,000. And that's the reality here. So you're going to see an increase in your taxes, and they don't see that coming. You got to help them see that, hey, this is what we're here to do. We're helping you to prevent this foreclosure, because one, we don't want you to have a foreclosure on your record, and two, we don't want you to have either a judicial judgment or deficiency judgment, or to be hit with the taxes, because the Mortgage Debt Forgiveness Act of 2007 no longer applies to you. So when you're knocking on these doors and you're talking to them, you got to help them see, because right now all they're seeing is they're just looking through these blinders and they're saying, I see one thing, and that the only thing I'm seeing is that I'm staying in my house. And you have to help them, you know, remove these blinders so they can see the reality of their situation. It's like, look, you know what, staying in your house is just temporary. You need to be able to look at the ramifications financially as well. And they can say, oh, my credit's fine. I don't care about my credit. It's already hit and damaged and whatever. And, you know, I got repos and credit cards in default and everything else. Hey, Mildred. And glad to have you here. And that's fine and dandy. But what they don't see is like also the tax ramifications. Because what will happen is at the end of the year, if they don't have the income to support the taxes, that increase, they're going to be hit with a pretty good a tax bill at the end of the year. And if they can't do that, then they're going to get fined. They're going to get levied. The IRS can put liens on their property, can levy their bank accounts. It could be, they can do a lot of things. You have to, you know, payment plans. It's not something to mess with. And so in order to help people really see the reality of their situation, this is what we do when we're knocking on doors. We're helping them understand, hey, you know what, we're here to help you financially as well as to help you emotionally. And, you know, that's what we do as bootstrappers. We look for opportunities to help people. And we also look for opportunities to be paid financially. And, of course, working with pre-foreclosures is one of the easiest ways to get out there and to not only help people, but also to help yourself to make a fair profit in the process. So, anyway, I'm Ryan Nicol. This is just another day in the life of a bootstrap real estate investor. And I had another investor reach out to me. He says he asked me about the question, and I realized that I had not addressed it previously. So, yes, the Mortgage Forgiveness Act of 2007 is no longer valid. It's no longer in effect. It was... It ended January 1st, 2017. So, all right, get at it today. go find somebody you can help. In the meantime, if you're gonna watch the eclipse, make sure you do it with some protective gear. And I'm gonna go ahead and enjoy that here the next half an hour with my family, and I'll see you all in the next one.